What is up, everybody? It's Christian. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Bros and Shows. I'm going to be your host today. My name's Christian. We're watching Shogun Episode 4, The Eightfold Fence, I believe it's called. And last week, we left off at a great moment. Now, Hatamoto, John, is swimming with Torunaga. And that was like just such a cool moment. Like the way they shot it felt so quaint and small, and the way they had him do like the diving lesson and then immediately challenged him to a race in swimming to the shore. Really cool. But overall, last week was awesome. So it started off following the events of the assassination attempt on John, Anjin, Hatamoto, whatever we're going to call him. Call him whatever you want, Blackthorn, you know, any of them. So we started there, and last week, was one of my favorite episodes so far because of the map scene and the way that all got kind of played out, which was incredibly cool. I really look forward to seeing them go on to train with John, because that's where Torunaga's sending his son and Yabushige. So last week, if you want a full breakdown, watch last week's episode. But more or less, they smuggled Torunaga out. Nobody knew the plan except for John and Mariko. The Kiyama Christian Samurai showed up. Very quickly, Torunaga broke out because his carrier caught on fire, and then there was like a battle amongst like Yubashige and his men and Torunaga's men and Ishido's men, and then Kiyama's men like took a break, but then they all chased them back. But the best part of last week's episode was definitely Buntaro sacrificing himself and staying back to defend, and then being seen on the dock, and the cuts back and forth between him and Mariko, and when Torunaga like stands up and shouts his name, and John is like trying to say like we can save him, and there's no way to save him. Like I was like really choked up and crying. Like that was like such an, like, I'm getting chills right now thinking about it. It was just so well done. And very seldom do you get these, like, you know, these awesome sacrificial moments that are just like executed flawlessly. And in my mind, they really did that. And then they swapped straight into like this political matter where they had to resolve like making an agreement with the Portuguese and the merchants on the black ship. And then Rodriguez and John are battling it out, trying to get out of the bay. All those boats waiting for them just got ran over by the black ship because there was nothing they could do. And then the swap back to their ship. Obviously, there was some negotiation, and Torunaga, you know, had to give up a lot, let them go, promise a church in Edo, all that. But really, like, just a really sick scene unfolding all the way from the ambush through to Buntaro sacrificing himself, and how emotional that moment was, right back into the, you know, the Game of Thrones kind of negotiations. So really, really like wild of an episode to end on this like happy, high, super bright note, like, oh, we've escaped. Now we're going to the fishing village and we're going to train. So really excited to see what happens this week. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Let us know what you think about the show. Let's get right to it. Oh yeah, I forgot about the sacrifice that Homie had to make. I didn't think he was gonna get killed too. That was like such a hard speech. Yo, and also when Torunaga confronted Yubashige, what a moment. John's antics preventing reveal that Torunaga was with them.
Fuck this.
I love that when he's like, fuck this, bro, I'm taking this ship out of here. She did say winter was coming, but already seeing snow is like, kind of quick. Oh, so they alerted him. But what did the note say? Like, did it? Sound design flawless, bro. just straight flawless. Chapter 4, The Eightfold Fence. I wonder what that means. Could be like a strategic reference. We were actually talking about a fence. So she's asking her to be the consort of John? Y'all both just lost your husbands. Yeah, they gotta literally get ready. Not necessarily.
Whose army is that?
Yabushige-sama's. All loyal to Toranaga-sama.
That's dope.
Let's hope so.
Yeah, you better hope so. It's in the Game of Thrones. Betrayal is afoot. Doesn't seem like everybody's happy about that, but...
The lord of this village.
Actually, we've met. Oyo Shao, and fuck yourself. You sniveling little shitbag.
Yeah, he definitely pissed on you, bro. He's got a good little guard there. Show of loyalty. First time we've kind of heard him speak like this. Dope. I support it. That's a flex right there, bro. Yabushige does not like these games, but he's with it. That's what she meant by they should have brought different sake.
Muraji.
Hi.
Hi. Welcome, Anjin-sama.
My men. I'd like to see them now.
Oh, man.
I
don't know if I believe that.
Look, maybe you can help me.
I'm afraid you are forbidden from boarding without permission. If there is something you need...
It's not yours anymore, bro.
My pistols and my men. Your lord and I had an arrangement.
Your ship and crew now belong to Toranaga-sama, and he will use them as he wishes.
Yep, don't be confused about how this works, bro. What are you gonna do, Blackthorn?
Anjin-sama, this is Ueijiro, the gardener.
Konnichiwa, Ueijiro-sama.
We do not use sama for Ueijiro. It is not proper. Your house is ready for inspection.
My house.
Showing more layers of the class system, or the division of them.
Everything here has been prepared specially by your staff.
My staff?
I don't think he likes that.
You will find your sleeping room as well as Fujisama's room. And the guest room where I will be staying.
Why have I been given all this?
It is only fitting for a Hatamoto.
Wait a minute. How long am I expected to be here?
Nagakato-sama-sei's training will take at least 6 months. You agreed to train these men, you remember?
I do, yes. For the return.
Harsh realities begin to set in. You can see him, like, kind of falling apart. He thought his return here was going to introduce him back to his men, but...
I don't want any generous
just to become, like, an indentured employee, basically. But, I mean, they saved your life.
Well, I'm sure she's very nice, but I don't want a woman. I wish to pillow on her, or near, or do any damn pillowing at all.
In any case,
he shows frustration, and Cosmo does really well. Like, I love his, like, little subtle acting.
To refuse would be a terrible insult to our lord.
I refuse all of this. I came here under clear terms with Toranaga. Sorry.
I wonder if this is gonna, like, sow some
Toranaga-sama.
Disrespect.
Now he's bloody vanished.
I don't want to be this guy, but I don't know how you expected, like, that to be much different.
Yatsume.
Yabushige painting is a hilarious concept.
I haven't found the rat yet.
It's a smart perspective on it. Like, you might as well take advantage of it now and, like, train all your men on it. Omi's got the fucking thoughts.
Go away.
He, like, doesn't know what to do with her. I hope that they, like, grow on each other. Because I like her. I feel bad for her. I feel like him and Mariko got a thing going on, though.
She won't let me alone.
It's not customary for one's consort to sleep while he's awake.
Well, it's a foolish custom.
You don't agree with any of their customs, bro.
You should not walk on moss. It is very disrespectful. Her husband had insulted Ishido-sama. And something had to be done in order to prevent bloodshed.
Shouldn't she be grieving, then?
Yeah, except for Toranaga's forced her to be your consort.
Marooned Englishman.
I like
the child's father served Toranaga-sama. Now being
the
your
juxtaposition
consort,
of how proper
the
they are and how brash he is. I get where Marco's
well,
coming from.
Never know
that,
to look at her.
Do you know of the Eightfold Fence?
Ooh, here we go. Episode title, she said the thing.
From the time we are small. It is something we are taught to build within ourselves. An impenetrable wall behind which we can retreat whenever we need. You must train yourself to listen without hearing. For instance, you can listen to the sound of a blossom falling or the rocks growing. If you really listen, your present circumstance vanishes. Do not be fooled by our politeness. Beneath it all, we could be a great distance away.
Wow.
And alone.
It's like sad and really cool at the same time. I really like that concept, though. Protecting yourself from the reaction to the harshness of a situation. Are those his pistols? Let's go!
Tell him he can go to hell.
Omi-sama insists it is forbidden to bring your weapons today.
Iie. Wakarimasu ka? Iie. Not his prisoner anymore.
Matsukasai, please! There is no need for this! You are protected.
That escalated real quickly.
For some reason, I just can't shake the memory of our first meeting.
Omi doesn't like you.
She will give her life to defend them.
I could damn well defend myself.
Anjin-sama!
Ooh. Is this going to develop mutual respect? I like her.
Tell this milk-dribbling fuck smear I'm ready to go.
The insult he has for Omi is so funny. Milk-dribbling fuck smear. I love her. That's so funny. Now he respects her. That's great. And he knows he has to respect her, too. Damn, that was funny as shit. And he just soars off.
That's very good.
I love this show. This is awesome. Out in the training grounds, eh? This is gonna be one of those, like, shoot the target over my head. Like, Last Samurai.
I will begin by describing for you a great battle. We call it the Siege of Malta. 60,000 Islamic Turks, the cream of the Ottoman Empire, had come against 600 Christian knights, supported by a few thousand Maltese auxiliaries at their vast castle complex at St. Elmo. Now, the knights had successfully withstood the six-month siege and incredibly had forced the enemy to retreat in shame. We are taught this victory saved the whole Mediterranean seaboard and thus Christendom.
Sorry, you said taught? So you yourself did not fight in this battle? You were not even born when this battle was fought. Describe a battle you have actually fought in.
Well, as I may have mentioned to your lord on multiple occasions, I'm a sea pilot, yes?
That's a good point.
Not a great deal of infantry battles at sea.
Didn't necessarily describe himself as a infantryman, so.
Please tell him that, in my opinion, gun tactics are useless compared to the fine art of English naval warfare. A castle in Nausicaa is impregnable, yes, with swords, even matchlocks. To lay siege would take months. Anchor my ship and cannon, and your army could breach the castle walls without so much as an arrow fletching to graze their cheeks. Just let me demonstrate. Would you mind hitting the wedge?
Pistol
charge. Prime.
But he's actually good, though. Let's see this. Watch him nail it.
Clear the hubs and fire!
John knows his shit, bro. This is dope. Well, guess we're learning cannons. Let's go.
Prime.
She's taking notes? What is she? So many things happening. I don't understand.
Imaichido, okikase.
Okikase kudasai.
Doing a good job trying to learn Japanese.
Kudasai.
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 This is gonna be cool, like all this time passing. I imagine a decent amount of chunk, or a decent chunk of time is gonna pass in this episode. I'm getting tired of the cannon fire. Is Mariko translating his books? What do we not know about him that she's gonna find out?
This is beautiful. The men are learning a decent amount at a decent pace.
Toranaga-sama will be pleased.
My Erasmus is a single ship, but a fleet would be something else entirely. My men in Edo could help me build him a navy.
Start building ships?
I think you should remember your oath is to Toranaga-sama, and not to the orders that brought you here.
What orders?
Your crimes against the Portuguese. I've read them in your own words. It will be useful for you to know our lord will never be turned against your enemies.
And it will be useful for you to be reminded that we are at war, both your lord and my queen, and it happens that we have enemies in common. Those were Catholics trying to kill him in Osaka.
Yes, trying to kill you.
Because they fear what I can offer him. A modern navy, ships built for war, would be to his benefit.
You have no idea.
So that's what he's here to offer them, eh?
We both have our masters to serve, don't we? Jin.
Fucking earthquakes, bro.
What the hell was that?
Just a baby earthquake.
A baby what?
Tsunami to follow?
There are also tsunami that come from the sea and fires that break out in the villages and cities. It is why our houses are built to go up as quickly as they come down. Because death is in our air and sea and earth. It can come for us at any moment. Just remember, we live and we die. We control nothing beyond that.
She's giving him so much, like, philosophical explanations. And I really enjoy the way that they wrap up her, like, little monologues with sound design. It's so impactful and beautiful, followed up by these unbelievable cinematic shots.
Chibi plotting.
God, it's so beautiful.
Bring forth a chain shot. Now, the chain shot increases the radius within which damage occurs and the nature of the damage itself. You'll see.
Oh shit. Are they about to have a for real battle? I did not see this coming. Are they here to talk or what? Yo. What's about to happen here?
いくさ自宅をしておるようじゃの。どうか分かりいただきたい。あの夜虎中が逃げ出すなどと、それがしは戦かもしらなんだのじゃ。王座かに戻り、大老将棋に双心なき旨を改めて誓い、戦技を受けようとの立ちである。断るともすか。それがしを殺せば、石堂様へ方へ味方を失うことになるぞ。されば心は決まっておるとな。お主が敵対の意を示したと知らせす。Oh man, this is tough for Yabushige, bro.
あの万人の持ってまいった王術は、それがしがこれまで見てきた王術とは物が違う。キリシタンの金太を縮み上がらせる代物よ。明日王術の演習がある。それを見て役に立たぬと思ったなら、この首慎んで石堂様に差し出そう。よかろう。I have bad feelings about that. 上前殿と、ご家来衆の宿所を用意いたせ。ご一行は明日王術の演習を見物なさる。
何故じゃ。我らの王術になりたいと考えてござる。おお、いや、I forgot. We're not gonna sun might not just be the fucking might not be down with this. Man, this is complex as fuck. Damn, that looks so good.
Mariko-sama, would you mind telling Fuji something on my behalf? I wanted to apologize for the way I behaved when I was first brought here. I'd like to thank her for her excellent service to this house. Ask that she accepts this gift as a gesture of my gratitude. Those are the best guns Sailor can have, and I'll miss that one.
He's gifting
quickly.
Her. One of but his pistols. That's cool. Well,
she'll need the best.
Protect yourself, Fuji. Come on, That was hilarious. Oh man, I loved that.
Defender.
Are those Buntaro's swords? Or no, oh my god, they belong to her father, okay. Sick, dude. What a moment.
I can't accept this.
Damn. Fuji-sama rightly points out that, as a Hatamoto, it is not proper for you to have no swords to carry.
Is he gonna learn how to, like, sword fight like a samurai now?
That'd
be so cool.
Get it right one of these bloody days.
I want to know what it is. Oh, it's the sticky bean stuff. I love that stuff.
It's a bit like cheese. Very stinky. Possibly spoiled cheese. Quite enjoyable.
The show's like in and out of being so emotional, and then I'm just cracking up over here. I think that's exactly what Omi wanted, bro. Which I also feel like is bad news. That worries me. What are you doing wandering away from the house, bro?
Beautiful. Sit.
Sorry. Fuji-sama said you were off on a walk.
Oh, Mariko.
Yes, I was.
I am happy to see you have changed your mind about bathing.
Would you care to sit?
Why is this so funny, bro?
I also wanted you to know you're wrong about my service in Ajiro. It has nothing to do with the church.
Go on.
I have not told you my family name, but it is well known in Japan. A great injustice stole everything from me.
What happened, bro?
I have been unable to seek resolution for what happened.
Like part of the civil wars?
But recently, Toranaga-sama offered me a way.
What sort of resolution? You said your houses here are designed to be rebuilt as quickly as they are destroyed. So if a house is ruined and rebuilt and ruined and rebuilt 50 times over, if I see it, I fail to see its ruins. I see only a house. And here I see a magic woman. And one who owes me no explanations.
Pretty honorable.
What is the name of it again? The city of your birth?
London.
A city like Osaka?
A city, yes, but nothing like Osaka.
Yeah, at this point in time, it's pretty... Filthy. I feel like, yeah, pretty gnarly in London.
What would you do there?
Well, if you were with me, all the way from the Japans, I'd take you to see my queen.
Would she receive us?
Oh, yes, I'm sure. And we tour the grounds, Richmond Palace, sit down for a stuffy dinner, and then to make up for it, I'd take us all to see a play.
This is a really cool moment between the two of them.
Suppose we go for a walk.
We'd sampo suru
along the Thames. It's a big river, runs right through the city, and at night it's quite something, and you can almost forget yourself and all your troubles and your past, and they all just disappear.
And then you are free.
I think so.
Man, I want to know more about Mariko and what happened to her. Is she vibing with John? Like, I like Fuji, but is she vibing with John, bro? Is she all scarred up too? This feels like a moment where she's finally figuring out, like, what she wants. And I think maybe that's John. Symbolic. Fuji, always taking care of homie. What is about to happen? Is it Mariko? Yo, who is it? It's Mariko. It has to be Mariko, right? It's happening. Oh my god. The silhouettes are crazy. Oh my god. Yo, and this music. Oh my god. This is blowing my mind. I was not expecting that.
Good morning.
You seem in good spirits.
As I should be, after a night of good company.
The courtesan was acceptable then. I'm glad to hear it. Which is a man I thought she would make a pleasing gift.
I don't understand. You're not, That was a very thoughtful gift.
I'm so confused. But that was amazing. And then the three of them just like sitting there watching the rain. Ugh, I love this. Such a nice break from all like the political nonsense and the shit going on. And that's, I feel like, what really makes a great show is when like you can have these little moments of character building and like hope and fun and love, and then go back to like obviously what is going to be a really tense moment, and how this shakes out like really means a lot for the rest of this story.
What's
he about to do, bro?
What's happening?
I do not know.
He's about to challenge him, bro. Line them up and crush them from across the field. With perfect accuracy. Holy shit, Nagakado.
Come on.
Oh my god, bro.
Do not intervene.
Dude, he's a savage. Damn, those Yabushige's homies. True.
Wow. Episode over. Oh my god, what the hell, dude? What is that? Oh my god. Yo. Holy shit. Dude, sometimes this show just blows my fucking mind. I was not expecting that whatsoever. That they absolutely crushed that episode. So cool to see time pass. So cool to like see the like under all this like discussion with Omi and how they pushed him to kind of even kind of do this and like create the situation. But Yabushige is kind of fucked. Like he can't like Ishido's gonna be pissed. But so. Starting off at the beginning, we got to the village, you know, Torunaga did his big, like, kind of flex, got everybody on his side, and then pretty much dipped out. And after that, it was just basically more or less training arc and character building and getting to know more about, like, you know, like, John and Mariko. And we still don't know a lot about what happened to Mariko, but Blackthorn at the beginning of the episode was really kind of struggling to get along with like this new life. I mean, obviously, like, you know, like, you know, Cosmo did an awesome job acting in that first part where he was just like flustered and frustrated and like going to be stuck there for 6 months and like didn't know that. And having Fuji as his consort and all these moments. And then slowly but surely he starts to really, I think, acclimate and get used to it. And with that moment with like Fuji pointing the guns at Omi and them and all that happening and then them training and the moment with him and Mariko where he's like, I haven't actually fought in like a war, but now he obviously taught them some useful tactics because they just took out like a whole little, you know, guard of Ishido's men, which is war. It literally means war. So the crazy transition between this like beautiful, beautiful, like intimate moment between Mariko and John at the like little spring into like seeing them, you know, engage in like intimacy for the first time. And then like going back to them talking about the Eightfold Fence is so cool because like now like Mariko has to show how she uses that to get her out of this situation because she's gonna have to be able to like be calm and cool and collected and hold John to be calm in this moment where they just like murdered a bunch of people. Jozen just got taken out by Nagakado and I don't know how Torunaga is gonna take that and handle that. Him going out on his own and striking the enemy first and basically like lighting the fire of war because Torunaga's got to be on like a campaign of trying to put people together. And I mean, the whole game here is going to be like keeping enough people on his side, even once they find out that he's resigned like from the Council of Regents. So I have no idea what's going to happen next episode. I think we might be going away from who we were just spending time with to find out some more things that were going on outside of the characters we just spent all of episode 4 with. I'm hyped, dude. That was wild. That was so wild. Wow. Yeah, a lot to digest in that episode. Favorite moment, probably like the intimate moment with him and Mariko, because like I just couldn't figure that out. But they both feel like they're on this like similar struggle. And I really like the love interest and having that emotion, especially like after she just lost her husband and is obviously going through it and he, you know, has nobody. So really crazy episode. The plot just deepens and gets thicker and thicker. I'm really interested to see where their relationship goes, like what Fuji ends up wanting to do, what Torunaga is going to do about this situation. And hopefully that's exactly where we're going in episode 5. So make sure you like, comment, subscribe, join our Discord, and we'll see you in episode 5. Let us know how you thought about the episode. This show is absolutely wild. And to all of our Patreon subscribers, thank you. We love you. We do have all the full-length episodes of this show as a watch-along on Patreon, so if you want to check those out, please do. But as always, this has been Bros and Shows. I'm Christian. My barking dog is Bodhi. He's sitting right here with me. But we appreciate you. Make sure you brush your teeth. Please brush your teeth.
I think my camera died, so this is going to be me talking with just like that face. Maybe I'll put like a moving mouth over it so it's like, you know. But that worked out well, right as I did my outro. Brush.